Oh, now. Hi, Internet.
Hey there.
All right. So,
Yep.
off the top for t okay, so at the end of last session, we found out some stuff about like we figured out the attempted murder mystery. This is pretty much what last session was. It was all solved. And now we're trying to figure out what to do with that information, how not to get killed by Cardinal Alinar, and stuff. In the meantime, I know one of Robbie's characters has a plotline pursuit he wants to go for sooner than later. Yeah, basically, you guys finish out the day last session, what we had for last session. You guys, what would you like to do? How would you like to pursue your various goals with your characters?
Well, Stellan has to fake his death, so
All right.
that's the thing that needs to happen.
How do you think he wants to go about doing that? Do you think that he might be able to
Well,
find some assistance in this?
he and Lionel were working on it together, right?
Yeah, that's fair.
So they were going to find a body, change it so that it looked like the woman Stellan had been impersonating, and then I suppose leave it someplace that one of Cardinal Alinar's other people could find or something, so that Lionel looks like he's still in with Cardinal Alinar.
Yeah. So yeah, Lionel's been set to task on that. I mean, is Stellan doing anything in particular to assist with this, or is he leaving Lionel to it and kind of quietly freaking out or
Well,
investigating?
if he can be helpful, he will be. But other than that, he might be like hanging around Lionel, getting as much information as he possibly can about the cardinal's movements, and potential weaknesses for potential assassination plots.
Sure. What is Jolie up to, and what are Thud and Pip up to?
Jolie is probably working her way through the murder room again.
Yeah, I mean, and at this point, she's getting the hang of it, so like, yeah, she's making progress on that. Thud, Pip.
Thud has like no motivation. He's just teaching what's her face.
Emira? All right, go ahead and
Yeah.
make an intelligence roll or wisdom roll.
All told, six.
Oh.
Okay. Yep. Teaching continues.
Yep. I'm gonna gather his trusty sidekicks and make his way to the manor, I guess.
Okay. Which trusty sidekicks?
Blue. Well, Blue and Lucky for sure. Should we bring Fiora too? Do you want him to bring Fiora? CFR?
Siofra, not Fiora.
I know,
Fiora,
not
different
Fiora.
character.
Oh my God. Oh goodness. Okay. Sorry.
When Pip goes to get his okay, there's scattered like drop points for messages and stuff around town, right? Lucky has already gone off and started like checking those around the town for the day.
What a good boy.
So he is indisposed. AKA, he may have made a cameo. But yeah, you can get, but Blue and Siofra are both available. And yeah. So yeah, okay, so after you get to the gate of the mansion, or the, yeah, you want to ring the bell or just kind of go in? Okay. No. All right. Bell ringing, thud, and Stellan and Jolie, you all hear the bell ringing.
Stellan's back in the manor by this point?
Yeah.
Okay. Jolie's going to assume that Butler Cat is on that.
I mean, yeah.
Stellan is not going to assume that Butler Cat is on that, but it's also not his home, so he doesn't feel licensed to let people in at the gate.
Yeah.
That is very tired of people ringing the bell, but he will slowly start making his way there, so Butler Cat will probably beat him there.
Butler Cat is there. The opening mechanism for the gate is high enough that it is difficult for Butler Cat to reach. So there is a solid, like, minute of Butler Cat trying to reach this mechanism with Pip and crew watching this. Until...
Has Pip met Butler Cat?
I don't think so. I don't think so.
No,
either.
So yeah, no, an animated stuffed animal comes out of the door, comes down to the gate, and proceeds to start trying to open the gate.
It's gonna watch Butler Cat and like turn and like sort of look glance at Blue and then turn and glance at CFO. And it's just gonna start slowly smiling and then watch Butler Cat and then go, I really like these guys.
Alright. I don't want my laptop to overheat, so I'm gonna. Hopefully the fan doesn't annoy you too much. Alright, so yeah, at this point, eventually, Butler Cat gets the gate open about the time Thud gets to the door.
Oh gosh. Okay. Pip's gonna spread his arms wide and go, friend! Is the small, lovely, angry one around?
She is not.
I guess she's not, right?
Yeah.
So that's gonna go, no. Pip's gonna be standing there with his arms open, like looking at that expectantly. And there's gonna be a beat where they're looking at each other. And Pip goes, well, who is around? Does Ted know who's around?
Roll perception?
Damn it. 10.
You know that Emira's in the house. You know that Jolie's in the house. That's all you know.
I know the kids are here. Is the scary one there? Yeah. Ooh.
Wait, who's the scary one?
The one that can fight and has a gun.
Oh.
Does
Pip is looking at Thud really expectantly, and Thud is just not doing anything.
Siofra is giving Pip a very unenthusiastic side glance.
Pip doesn't acknowledge it. Oh my god, how am I gonna get everyone in the den? Okay.
So I guess welcome to my world.
Well, can I maybe have come in for some tea?
Butler Cat eagerly runs in ahead and starts making tea.
That still is just like looking at Pip, trying to figure out what he wants to do. Pip is still just kind of like looking at Bud. Then I guess Bud's gonna like shrug and say, I guess. And lead him inside. Funded!
As you get inside, Emra like is there watching, and kind of seeing the guest kind of ducks back behind the corner into the dining room, and then after a second you hear her run downstairs.
Pit goes, charmed.
Jolie, at this point, Emra runs to join you in the murder room. and like comes and like looks at you for a second and then like doesn't want to interrupt you, but like walks up next to you and just like sets a flower down next to you and then turns and runs back upstairs.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm gonna take the flower, inspect it. Is there anything particular about it that I would notice? Is this like a Victorian language of flowers thing? Is she trying to like communicate something to me?
Roll history.
I think I have a history bonus. Wow, damn. Yeah, I think I do. Give me a second. So yeah, I got a 22.
I mean, yeah, you look at it and you're pretty sure it's a lily of some kind, which usually is like a funereal flower. So you're pretty sure that that's not like what she meant.
Right. It's not like a death unto you.
Yeah.
Kind of thing.
So
I am literally in the murder room though, so you know, asking for it.
It's true. It is a little ominous.
Jolie is gonna have an uncharacteristic yearning just to go hang out with Emra and play. She's gonna be like a little tired of work.
Yeah, well, I mean, also this has kind of been what she's been up to for like days, because she just did this. She just solved it.
Right.
And is doing it again.
Right.
So
yeah, she's not thrilled about that. Especially since they made like specific plans about going back to see the Sphinx, so now she has to, and it's like a job. It's not just like something fun she's doing. Yeah. So she's tired. She's clocking out, and she's gonna go kind of toddle upstairs.
Yeah.
See what's what.
Thud. You get upstairs and you see Thud and Pip and two characters you have not seen before. Siofra is a white-haired woman, keeps it her hair tied back, and dresses a little differently. Like you don't know off the top of your head what like culture, but it's not like the culture of Vale. She doesn't look like she's dressed in city person garb. Then there is Blue, who is apparently a woman in heavy armor, but it appears, I'm not sure how to describe this. The character is trans, but doesn't like, is not, is a trans male who is not, who does not, describe, help me out, Robbie, does not like outwardly present.
He doesn't present like fully male. He very much presents sort of like intersexually and androgynously.
Okay. Cool.
So yeah.
So, Jolie, if there's no like conversation going on, and honestly, 9 times out of 10, even if there is,
I mean, you might walk in on Pip, like, asking a question that Thud doesn't really respond to very well.
Cool. Well, Jolie is going to, like, immediately go for Siofra. Is that her name?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Siofra.
And say, hi, what's your name? My name is Jolie Mudbrook.
She looks at Pip. Which one's the scary one?
He smiles and points at Jolie.
She nods dutifully, but looks a little skeptical also, and looks back down and is like, my name is Siofra.
Where are you from? What kind of clothes are those, and where did you get them, and why are you wearing them here, and what are you doing, and are you a friend of Pip's?
I am a friend of Pip's. I'm a friend of, side glance, Pip's.
Pip winks.
Then looks down and is like, I'm from an island nearby here.
What's it called and how far away is it? And what kind of culture is it? What kind of cuisine do they have?
It's a few miles out and it does not have a name because people don't live there. Except my mom.
That's interesting. Who's your mom and how did she come to live there?
She is, she's like, kind of pauses, like, she's a sea witch, and they put her there because she gobbles up curious children.
We have our tea yet?
Can I tell if she's, telling the truth or not?
Go ahead and roll insight. At this point, Butler Cat comes up with the tea.
Pip, like, bows and takes his tea and, like, nods his head.
Butler Cat bows back.
Cheers. Then he, like, turns to continue watching his conversation and sips his tea.
I rolled pretty low. I got, like, a 9, so my guess is...
I mean, yeah, you can't tell. So you know that sometimes, for some reason, adults don't tell you what you're the answer to what you're asking.
Right.
And so you're not completely sure.
Okay. So
Thud, at this point, Emra kind of comes up behind you and kind of puts a flower in your hands.
Does Thud have any idea what that means?
Roll insight.
Like, what? Like, any idea why she's doing this? 16.
You haven't seen these on your guys' grounds.
I'm gonna, like, look at them and, like, look at Emma and be like, where did you get these?
I made it.
Oh.
And she hides behind Thud.
It is, like, looking at the group very scrutinizingly and, like, scratching his chin. Is, like, anyone else around?
Well, Stellan is, Stellan, like, hanging out somewhere.
Yeah, you're probably upstairs, and you, at this point, like, can hear them downstairs.
Your so call Stellan if you want to come out. Stellan probably immediately wanted to, like, see Zanar whenever he got back, but I'm guessing Zanar was already gone. Maybe not.
Zanar is off. Zanar has not really been sleeping and is off, like, researching something. Whether or not Stellan has been clued in on that's kind of up to Charlene. But
okay.
He's been very preoccupied.
Okay, so I guess Stellan's going to hear voices and then come down to see if Dinar is one of them. And he's not. So he kind, like, of, like, goes into the... Sorry?
Yeah, Dinar is not one of them.
Right. So Stellan kind of, like, hovers in the doorway and kind of looks around and is like, oh, sorry. And then sidles off.
Can I roll stealth?
You can, yes.
Natural 17, so a lot.
What are you doing?
I just want to, like, when Stellan turns, I just want to pop up on the other side of him and just kind of, lean against the wall and go, hi.
Straight up Looney Tunes moment.
Yeah.
Hi.
You, and he, like, puts his finger on Stellan's chest, and, like, are just the type of person I was looking for.
I am.
Ding, ding,
I'm
ding,
half teeth.
ding.
What is
Is there someone ringing at the gate?
Oh my God!
it? It like turns and looks at the noise and then looks at Thud expectantly.
Butler cat runs out.
Thud gives a really big sigh and then gets up and starts walking towards the gate.
I mean, you guys are like right by the door. You kind of looking out the door and take a few steps. Colton Vale is at the gate.
Oh my God, Stellan is gonna make a beeline.
Bud sees him and then turns and stops and like turns around and just goes back to sit down.
Stellan is gonna
Brushes
go
past
straight out there toward Colton.
him. So you get to the gate. Colton is there and is like, I have intel on where Alinar is right now, unguarded.
Yes. Let's do it. Let's get it. Let's go for it.
Pip is gonna be super nosy. Can I roll perception or something for him?
I mean, yeah, you're several hundred feet away at the moment, so
I
DC is
know.
pretty high.
But he could tell that it was, what's his face, right? Colton?
I mean, if he walked over and looked out the door, yeah, he probably could.
I don't know that he would immediately, but he would eventually.
I mean, at this point, Colton, looks at Stellan and is like, is it just the two of us?
I could ask. I don't really. I'm not
At
in
this point.
great standing with these people.
Pip is gonna now look out the window, I guess, and see that it's Colton. And then he's gonna like pop out. I'm like, wait, hi! And then run up. Like, what are you doing here?
I had some business with Stellan and kind of
Why?
eyes Pip warily.
Stellan is gonna turn to Pip and smile and say, little free word association here. What would you think if I said Cardinal Alinar?
He's gonna get like a blank stare and then narrow his eyes and then he's gonna like give Stellan a really like long like look down and then up and then smile and say slime ball.
Interesting. How would you feel if you lived in a world in which he wasn't around?
We create a considerable vacuum in the city,
Yes.
creating a space for chaos and opportunity.
Yes, pits and ladders. How would you like to take part in making that world a reality?
Well, I wouldn't not like that.
How about your friends?
You don't have to worry about them. They'll do whatever I tell them.
Great. I know that you and I probably have about as good a read as each other do on the people who actually live in this house. Do you think this is the kind of thing I should approach them with? Or, because like my sister's gone and Dinar's gone, so I feel like all of my connections here are not here. Technically, I probably shouldn't be here. But I just thought maybe, do you think like the big guy who hates me.
Kind of like reach out and put his finger over Stellan's lips to touch him. Well, from everything I've seen about intel, I think they're pretty murderous enough.
Fair. Let's, maybe we could go ask them.
Pip's gonna, like, steeple his fingers and say, sure, but how about a little prid quo? Wait, prid quid pro quo?
Did Pip flub it, or?
Sure.
Stellan is going to kind of give an amused smile at the little flub, and then is going to say, sure, what would you like?
It seems that Raiden has captured one of our people, indicating the thief guild, and I'd very much like to rescue him.
That seems fair. Yeah, that seems fair. We could do that.
Excellent. Colton holds out his hand for a handshake.
Colton says, and I heard none of that.
Thank you. Stellan is going to turn to Pip and say, it's cool, though, if we go after this cardinal first, though, right? Because I think this is sort of a immediate thing that needs to happen. It's very time sensitive.
Pip's going to give him a side glance and go, well, do you have anything to sweeten the deal?
I could probably play your favorite song. It's basically the only thing I have.
A musician. Okay, sure, let's get the others.
Yes. It's literally never worked for me.
Colton is holding a cup of tea that Butler Cat gave him and is looking at Butler Cat incredibly confused, and then turns his head and is like, is this safe to drink?
Stellan is going to look at Pip, who has been drinking the tea, inquisitively.
I mean, I don't know, you may be trying to poison him.
It does not acknowledge this conversation.
Stellan is gonna say, we gotta go soon anyway, so I wouldn't.
slowly gives the teacup back to Butler Cat, who walks away slightly dejected.
Aww.
Thud, have you been listening to this?
No.
Okay.
So Stellan is going to go back in to the house and awkwardly address himself to the room full of people and say, so Pip and I are going to go help Colton Vale with something. It's a little dangerous, and we'd like some assistance, and I didn't pitch that very well.
Emira says, I'll help.
Maybe not the tiny children.
Pip goes, what's his name? Alinar?
Yeah.
We're going to kill Alinar.
Emira's face goes from very happy to very not happy. And she kind of backs up and hides behind Thud again.
Thud is just like deadpanning, like glaring at Pip. And then turn and look, and deadpan glare at Stellan, and just look at him expectantly.
Stellan, I don't think Stellan would know that Emira is Eleanor's daughter, would he?
I don't think so.
No.
So Stellan's gonna kind of look at Thud and say, what?
Are you asking us for help?
I'm asking if you would be interested in helping. to take out a massive threat to the city who has acted against us in a bunch of ways, and we would be better off if he weren't around. Also, he wants me dead, so there's that.
Sun's gonna give like a really besotten sigh, and then stand up again. And I guess he's gonna turn to Emra and like pat her on the head and say, "Why don't you go make flowers or something?"
And she kind of, I don't know, her expression is very like, this is above her, but she's also like quite upset, but she does kind of like back out of the room. And
I'm gonna turn back and shrug and go, "Sure.
Great, this is so exciting. Okay, awesome, let's go. I mean, I think this is pretty time sensitive, so we should maybe hit the road."
Jolie, you are in the room for this.
Jolie's gonna do what everyone else is doing. She hasn't gotten to talk to Blue yet, so if Blue's going, she's probably gonna follow and ask questions.
Blue's a local and is a well-trained fighter. Jolie probably finds fairly quickly that, like, in terms of like arcane knowledge, Siofra has a little more to offer. And by a little more, I mean like Blue doesn't use magic. I think that's true. Isn't that true? Let me double check. It is technically possible for fighters to use magic. All right. Computer's picked up. Blue does not use magic. But I mean, he does seem to have at least a gadget you might find interesting. It's kind of it's pretty much a straight up Legend of Zelda hookshot. Launches out, sticks into something, and pulls the user to the thing.
Hey, cool.
Or the thing to the user if it's lighter. Aside from that, I'm not sure specifically what I get from Blue. And Blue spends the entire conversation kind of looking to Pip to try and ascertain how much he should be telling.
Pip doesn't acknowledge any of these looks.
I'm pretty sure they're used to that at this point. So they just kind of use their best judgment. Colton leads the group towards the front of the city. You roll perception.
Okay.
Oh, by the way, I think Fudd. I'm trying to think if Thud would have brought
Biscuit.
The giant hyena. Did we ascertain, is this going to be like a stealthy mission?
I don't know. I don't think we've really talked about that.
I know.
So Jolie got like a 7 and Stellan got a 17 on perception.
Thud got a 21 and Pip got a 20.
Thud is the only one who notices, quite a ways back, at least for the first little bit of them traveling down the road, Emira is following them.
What? Who notices? Thud?
Thud.
Thud's gonna stop. He'll kind of like say, ugh, give me a moment. He's gonna go back. Do I have to like roll to see if I can find her?
I mean, no. You saw her.
Okay, I'm gonna just like walk up to her and like look at her.
She kind of frowns and is like, oh, I was just gonna go see what, I was gonna go see the ship with at Callahan's, and kind of points. Like, it is the same direction on in the road.
Yeah, this will solve the problem. That's gonna, like, gesture, Biscuit over, and then say to Biscuit, take her home.
Biscuit kind of picks her up, and yeah, I'm pretty sure Biscuit's gonna beat that strength check, so she seems resigned to her fate, if unhappy about it.
And Thud's gonna go rejoin the group.
Stellan is going to ask Colton what they should expect.
He set off on the road on his own. If we leave quickly enough, we can catch him and take him out, hopefully without any witnesses. He's like keeping his voice down, so it's just between him and Stellan as best as possible, unless someone wants to.
Oh, Pip wants to hear, though.
Okay, then roll perception.
Eighteen.
I mean, yeah, that'll be enough. You hear.
Pip goes, that sounds hella suspicious.
Stellan's gonna ask Colton how he knows this.
I've had people watching him for a while. I mean, we talked about this.
Right, yeah, no, we did. We definitely did talk about this. Do you have any idea what he's doing? Why he set out alone?
Nope.
Probably laying a trap.
Colton shrugs. It's possible, but...
I mean, Thud, like, looks at Colton, like we've met the same Alamar, correct? Like, you know this person. Do you think he would go somewhere by himself?
He's pretty strong. Most people wouldn't be able to do anything to him, even if they tried, even if he was on his own. I'm not convinced I'd be able to on my own.
Right, well, I never said he wasn't strong. I just thought he wasn't stupid.
Stellan is going to say, should we get some kind of tentative plan in the works?
I'm all ears.
Okay, Stellan's going to kind of tentatively look over at Pip to see if he has any ideas.
Pip's going to wink at him, when we get close enough, the three of us should be able to disappear quite well. We wanted to organize a type of ambush attack. I don't know about the extent of your abilities.
Right. They're not great. I do feel very strongly that he should die, but that's really the most I have going for me right now, so...
Can't you turn in? This is not Pip. Can you turn invisible?
Yeah, I can. Yeah, I can turn invisible personally, and I also have an unseen servant. Yeah. And then Jolie, if she overhears this, but Stellan hasn't really been trying to be quiet, would pipe up and say, "I have an invisible person." So we have invisible people. we could use invisibility. That's good.
At this point, you're getting near like the guard station and the city gate to be able to leave the city. Colton is still trying to talk quietly, because
as soon as they get near the guards,
yeah,
they're gonna probably be quieter.
That's gonna wave to the guards.
Let's see who's on. Oh wait, that's right. They're freaking Brayden's men, so they give him a stern look.
While waving and smiling, Pip's kinda like whisper under his breath to Stellan, "Don't worry, I'll kill all of them."
Wasn't worried. Not worried about that. Worried about a lot of things, not that one.
You guys get out onto the road, you get through the gate and out onto the road, and it's a well-traveled road. It's the same road as you guys face down Ovak and crew on, so.
Oh, shit. Pip's gonna sidle up to Stellan and go, "So, last I saw, you seemed to be hitting it off pretty well with that lizard."
I assume that's offensive, and, I mean, I can't really speak for the Dragonborn, but it doesn't seem like the kind of thing that they would want to be called. They're a very dignified race. But yeah, I mean, we are, you know, engaged, so we should be hitting it off.
Well, it seemed like there was a history there.
Yes, engaged people often have history of some variety. Seldom are they just meeting for the first time already engaged. And this is not one of those rare occasions.
It seemed like there was maybe a bit of drama in the past.
Drama? Nah. No.
Melt the sweet smell of betrayal.
Oh, interesting that has a smell. Do you have synesthesia by any chance? Is that something? I've always wondered about that.
I really want
synesthesia. Betrayal is a strong word, and in the eye, I imagine, of the beholder. So, do I feel betrayed by Dinar? No. At no point in our relationship have I ever had cause to feel betrayed by Dinar. He is a stalwart, wonderful, wonderful person who deserves everything good.
I was gonna tilt his head and go, "Aww, what did you do to him?"
Yeah, can we maybe get back to planning an assassination of a major political figure?
I just really feel like if I'm about to assassinate someone with a person, you know, I like to get to know that person first.
There are a lot of people here who are part of this assassination crew. Lots! What do you know, for example, about Jolie here? She seems interesting. Probably lots to unpack there. Colton, the Colton Vale, is a very interesting person.
Oh, I know lots about Colton Vale.
Yeah, wow. I can't tell if it's just your tone or if there's really... You know, it always seems like you... Never mind. I'm not gonna... Anyway. He's gonna turn to Colton and he's gonna say, how far away do you think we are? No?
He set out probably 45 minutes ago, so we should catch up. I mean, we need to be keeping a faster pace than him, but I think we are. If my best guess would be a couple hours.
Oh god. We can't move faster. There's no option for moving faster.
Pip goes, I like to take my time.
Right, okay. Okay. Alright. Okay, fine.
Fudd's gonna sidle up. Helen and go, oh wait, that's right, Fudd knows the whole Gantam story. Wait, does Fudd know the whole story? What does Fudd know? I don't even remember.
Of what story?
It's Helen and Dinar.
Yeah, Fudd knows it.
Does he know, like, the whole thing? Or did he just, like, get the gist of it?
I thought he knew the whole thing.
I don't know. Romantic backstory was, I think, given to Jolie. And I don't think to anybody else. Everybody else just saw, like Dinar reacting to Stellan's reappearance.
But they did get the, you were dead.
Right.
Now. Like, I mean, that, and then a lot of unwanted, like, additional information that just kind of
right
happened. So, like, I mean, I'm pretty sure
some TMI moments.
Yeah, so you've got, like, I mean, Thud has the, Thud has the story, at least the broad strokes of it.
Oh no, Thud's gonna walk up and go, yeah. I think he tried to do some kind of weird con or something on Dinar. Pretended to be dead or something. I don't know. His sister was his wife. It was some. I'm just gonna go, like, why does this and go, oh. look at Stella and go, oh, did you fall in love with your mark?
that's a way of summarizing it, I suppose. Sounds oddly condescending when you say it in that fashion, but yes, I guess it's accurate.
Amateur.
Well, it was my first con, so yeah, definitely rookie move there.
Okay. So after, I'm willing to time jump when you guys want. So let me know when you.
I think Stellan would come out with his side of the story.
Okay.
Now that the ungenerous version is out there. So he would definitely be telling Pip, but whether Thud wants to listen in or not is up to Thud.
I mean, Thud is listening because it doesn't seem like Stone's going anywhere, so he's gonna make the most out of this.
So Stellan's just gonna sort of explain, like, yeah, we were young and we were really stupid and kind of caught up in ourselves, and we left our moms and kind of just decided to travel. We didn't have anything, and so we thought, well, we'll scam whatever first traveler who's traveling alone we run across. So the first pub we get to, we hear them talking about this dragonborn who just left, and, you know, they're talking, and we'd never seen a dragonborn before. We didn't know anything about them. So we were asking about dragonborns, and they were saying, oh, dragonborns always have all this gold, and they never spend it. They just, like, carry it around. They hoard it. And yet he was traveling alone. He's really antisocial. And so we thought he would be a really easy mark. We found him, and we were able to kind of arrange, like, a meet cute where I just stumbled across his camp, and I asked for food, and I pretended I was starving, and then he fed me, and he was really nice, and he took me in. And anyway, I mean, you know, I'd never seen anyone like him before, and I just was really impressed by him, and one thing led to another, and it was only supposed to be, like, a day, but I kept telling Azria that I needed a little more time, and then it was like a week, and then Azria came and she shamed me, and she said that I needed to wrap it up. So we faked my death. We pretended that I'd been like gored by this boar, and we like left my clothes and something that I'd cast an illusion spell on to look like it was, you know, part of me, that the boar had left behind. And so he found it and he was really upset. And then the next day Azria came along and she pretended to be my wife who was looking for me and who had found me dead and who had to like now host a funeral for me. And she asked if Dinar had known me. And so she asked for money and he gave her all the money that he had. And so the con worked, but then after we left and we had all the money, then I just felt really bad. And then the longer time went by, I felt worse and worse. And I just couldn't stop thinking about him. And so anyway, I just made sure that we never did cons like that again. It didn't seem right after that.
Well, it wasn't bad for your first con. No, it did rely pretty heavily on you finding a generous mark, which I gather you did.
Right, yeah. No, he did have a lot of money. I'm not saying that the stereotypes are true. I'm just saying, like, this particular Dragonborn did happen to be hoarding a lot of gold.
Yeah, okay, out of character, I just... are Dragonborns hoarding money? Is that, like, a racist stereotype?
It is now.
It's one that we made up.
Okay. And then I guess Pip's gonna go, and I guess as far as lizards go, not as pretty good, but... Or watch out in general. I wouldn't spend too much time around them, if you know what I mean.
I don't know. Huh. What? I'm not familiar with the implication that you're clearly doling out.
And then Thud's gonna go, if you fell in love with him, why did you carry out the con?
I guess I didn't really see another option, and I've really kind of cursed myself every day since then for not standing up to Azria, for not realizing that that was really how I felt. I don't know. It's definitely the one thing I would redo. And I fucked up a lot, so that's saying something.
I was gonna say, it was very stupid.
Yes. Yeah. You're very right. I have nothing to say to myself.
Anything else either.
Awkward silence ensues.
Yeah.
Jolie's furiously taking down notes about all this.
Yes. She's going to compare this version of events and Dinar at some other point.
After traveling for a bit, you guys do see a small cart up the road, pulled by one horse.
Oh, goody.
Maybe we could have the cart break down. Like, we could have something happen to the axle or something, so then he has to be like he's fixing the cart, and then that's when we ambush him.
Sure.
Can you do that? I don't know. Jolie is going to pipe up and say, I could send my invisible golem to do it.
Well, shall we stealth?
Yeah, at which point your crew stealths.
So,
some better.
Jolie's gonna make. Jolie's gonna make a furtive filter then, and send it ahead. First, she's going to verify that this is Cardinal Eleanor's cart.
As the filter. Well, roll perception.
Um, 14, and then whatever you add to the filter's perception. Plus 6, so 20.
So you do spot. Okay, so is this happening at the same time as the thieves are getting in position?
Well, I figured that we were gonna break the cart first before anyone got in position.
Before they got in position?
We should be in position. Then when he comes out, we take him.
Okay. All right. I just figured we'd wait until he was like fixing the cart, but that's cool.
All right. So you rolled stealth, right, Pip?
Yeah. Thud did too, because
why not?
Thud got 12. Pip got 22.
What do you add to stealth? Dex?
Dexterity, yeah.
Yeah.
Just gonna see if Jolie does it. Nope, not really. Jolie got like 12.
That's not the worst of the group.
Oh jeez.
So in a fairly uncharacteristic display, everyone just into the like woods like around the road to spread out around it. Except for apparently Siofra, who just like didn't like get the message quickly enough, so suddenly just boom, and she's just by herself in the road. She's like, and kind of goes and like attempts to hide on the side, but is not doing a great job. She's not representing very well at the moment. But even Colton's fairly decently hidden. So
did the filter, can the filter see if it's Eleanor or not?
At this point, the filter gets in view and sees the person on the back of the horse guiding the cart is not Eleanor. Eleanor does appear to be in the cart. With five more individuals. This whole unguarded thing turns out not to have really been accurate.
Jolie is she anywhere near Colton?
Who did you follow into the woods when you stealthed?
I mean, probably Thud.
Then probably not.
So Jolie is going to report that, as a matter of fact, there are five people in the cart and there is another one driving the horse. Does the filter recognize any of them? Because the filter would be able to tell anyone Jolie knew.
You roll intelligence real quick.
Thirteen.
You recognize Graynor.
Motherfucker.
I mean, if these are all like his inquisitors, and we probably shouldn't fight them.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. So is the cart an open back cart?
Yeah, it's an open back cart. It's not like wide open. The opening's fairly small. There's a lot of canvas there, but.
So Jolie has told Thud that this is a full house.
That like look there, like look at the car, and then like look out into where everyone's hiding, and then look at Jolie, and then kind of like, can your thing go find like Pip or Stellan and tell them that?
Maybe Jolie's gonna, just in case, Jolie's gonna like put on her glasses and look at the cart and think like, is there anything that I could do to this cart that will make it explode, action movie style?
Oh dear. You start getting very detailed text on the process you need to undertake to learn the fireball spell.
Are there any like cliffs around here or anything like that?
I mean, no. There's the river a little ways up. That's the only major landmark. You remember the river you guys went into the Feywild in one time and then at another point like swam or like walked underwater.
Hey now. We can't possibly send them to the Feywild, can we?
I mean, you could try. You had a threshold crest last time.
We don't have anything like that this time.
Not really.
Just a bar.
Yeah, you could try. You could try and like push them into the bar and push them through the door. I'm sure Delight would be happy about that.
Oh God, this is so painful, and I definitely don't want to have a fight with all of these people. I was so ready for a fight with Eleanor, and then this is just very overwhelming for me.
Pip is starting to get impatient.
Okay, so Jolie is going to send the furtive filter back to try to find Pip or Stellan or Colton or
roll,
anybody else.
Roll perception.
Oh my gosh.
It has a plus 6 on perception, so maybe. Okay, 23.
Oh, you find Pip.
Okay, so the filter goes up to Pip and tells it that there are, in fact, 6 non-Eleanor people. Is that right?
That is correct.
And at least one of them seems to be Eleanor's, like, Inquisitor, so there's a likelihood that the some of the others are as well, and these are pretty serious, seriously strong people.
Howdy boy. Pip wants to see who's on the cart. So Pip, you ready to roll stealth again? He kind of just wants to do a flyby.
I'm going to make you roll perception during the flyby, but I'll keep your stealth roll.
Okay.
And I'll have... They're going to roll perception.
Perception... I rolled a 16 for perception.
I mean, you're roughly familiar with Alinar, but unless you'd dedicated significant resources into finding out the identities of his inquisitors, you probably wouldn't know. You know Greynor is, because that kind of became pseudo-public knowledge after he got revealed.
I mean, what about the chick who blows things up? She seems like a BFD.
I mean, yeah, but is there any reason Pip would have interacted with her?
I don't know. He doesn't want to get blown up.
you look
at
him.
If he doesn't recognize anyone, he doesn't recognize anyone.
I mean, yeah, he really doesn't. You do see that at least one of the other people in the cart appears to be a more than average fighter.
Are there any women in the group?
Yes.
Okay. I was like, if there's no women, then at least blow up chick isn't there. But anyway. Okay, so Pip's kind of settled down.
Yeah, at this point, the cart continues for a few feet and then slows and stops.
Lovely.
Okay.
So Pip's gonna ping everyone with Messenger. I guess one at a time if he has to, because I don't think group chat's a thing. And say, so it seems like he's not in fact alone and has seven other people with him, one of which is I know is an Inquisitor, and the others could all be Inquisitors, I guess. I don't really know all his Inquisitors, but one of them is, and if the others are, then we're pretty boned, and it looks like they're slowing down, so they might have spotted me, and so we're maybe a little in danger at the moment.
From Colton, you get ping back, because you can do that with message. That doesn't make sense. My intelligence has no connections to Alinar. It wouldn't make sense for this to be a setup.
Oh no, Alinar leaving all by himself doesn't sound like a setup.
I'm saying it doesn't make sense for this person to have set me up.
Stellan is really upset with Colton, and he's not hearing this, but he's immediately going to message Colton and say, what? Who gave you this information? Where is this coming from?
I've got guards and people spread out throughout the city that are, I thought, were loyal to me, but it doesn't make sense that they'd be working for Alinar.
Oh my god, okay.
Did it make sense to be working for Alinar?
Well, so could they possibly be working for anybody but you?
I mean, they work for the city, for the kingdom, for my mom, but and I've there was a roll. I pretty thoroughly vet my guards.
Yes, well, even thoroughly vetted guards can turn against you, just ask Lord Brayden.
Right, so I think we should probably get out of Dodge.
I'm on board with that.
At this point, the woman in the cart you saw has short red hair. She is elven and steps out in full scale mail, and steps out looking at the sky. Appears to have seen something gone by. What is your... Oh, shit. She looks up, doesn't see anyone, looks down the road, and sees Siofra kind of badly obscured in the brush over there. And starts walking toward her with a purpose. Also,
oh
a broadsword.
Oh my god. Pip is gonna message Siofra and say, we're gonna have a long talk about this when we get home. And then he's gonna, like, grandly emerge from wherever he's hiding and say, Alinar, buddy, pal, how's it going?
At this point, all the people in the cart, except for Alinar staying in the cart, jump out, and Graynor immediately stares at and squares off with Pip.
Okay.
Pip's gonna motion over Siofra to come join him.
The filter, if this is fair game at all, the filter is going to... So literally everyone but Alinar is off the cart.
Correct.
The filter is going to sting the horse.
Roll stealth.
Oh my god.
Wait for the filter. With advantage... Well, no, it's all...
It has a +10 on stealth.
Yeah. It also can turn invisible, but you lose invisibility when you do an attack, so...
Right. So, I don't know, did you mean to say with advantage or no?
We'll say with advantage approaching the horse. We'll figure out exactly how shit's gonna fall out. 20?
29.
Yeah, no one knows, I mean... yeah, as it approaches, one guard seems to, like, turn his head that direction, but isn't moving against it.
So it stings the horse?
All right, go ahead and roll for the attack. What are fucking horse stats?
So 19.
That hits. Go ahead and roll damage.
One D4 plus 5. So 7.
All right. Yeah, congratulations, you stung the horse.
I specifically tried to sting it in the rear so that it maybe might run.
Yeah, at this point, the guard who turned his head sees the horse start to rear and is going to do an animal handling check. Yeah, you stung the horse, but he seems to kind of reel the horse back in and calm it down. But is looking around for what startled it. Which at this point, your messenger is no longer invisible, so he looks over and sees the thing having stung the horse.
Even my stealth check doesn't... I can't, like, stealth it again?
I mean, at this point, we pretty much have to enter initiative to determine how the stuff goes. But essentially, the furtive filter's action would be to sting the horse, and then it would not get.
I can't stealth the bonus.
No, stealthing is an action unless you specifically have the cunning action ability that lets you stealth as a bonus action. While this is going on, what is the dialogue?
I don't suppose I see any of that happen.
I mean, yeah, you're looking at the cart you see the horse rear back and the person calm it down. You may not see the filter.
Do I see the filter?
Roll perception.
Do I need... Plenty.
Yes, you see the filter.
It's gonna go, oh, hold on, pesky bee, and then draw his bow and make an attack on the filter.
Go ahead and roll the attack.
Okay, I'm trying to figure out what... bonuses do we get? It's not a sneak attack.
Technically, it is in melee with a hostile target. So, yes?
What's yes?
It is you can sneak attack it if you want.
Oh, sure.
Is it hostile or does it have to be an allied target? Okay, let me double check that. Go ahead and roll for the attack generally first. See if you hit.
Yeah, I'm just trying to figure out like what I get because all my hit bonuses and subtractions. The sharpshooter.
Oh, if you're sharpshootering it, then you're gonna... Okay, if you're sharpshootering it, then you're gonna have a total of +5 to whatever you roll.
Yeah, I'm just trying to figure out if I also have advantage on that.
Oh, yeah, that's fair. For sneak attack...
Oh, wait, sneak attack just gives me extra damage. What gives me...
You don't need... if another target is within 5 feet, then I need... That's per turn. Okay, yes, you will get sneak attack, but your attack is not at advantage because that's not the means by which you're triggering your sneak attack. It's a weird rule thing, but yeah. So just a straight roll, add 5 to it if you're doing sharpshooter, add 10 to it if you're not doing sharpshooter.
Okay, I'm not gonna do sharpshooter, I just wanna hit it.
Sure.
Oh, fuck.
What'd you roll? Natural 1?
I did.
As soon as you draw your bow, all of them, like, pull out their weapons, and the whole thing just escalates.
Oh, God!
Graynor pulls out his kind of double blade thing. We're all rolling initiative. Everyone roll initiative.
Oh, God. I'm so sorry. Do you add something to initiative?
Dexterity.
I always forget. Okay.
All right. So...
I can't believe this fucking bullshit.
Okay, so Jolie got a 9, Stellan got a 20, and the filter got... Sorry. Eleven?
Okay, filter got 11. Jolie got a
9, and Stellan got 20.
All right, Robbie.
Pip got 19, and then got 14.
And then I need to roll for Colton. Uh, kind of can't believe this bullshit.
You're telling me? Oh my god. So stupid.
So you guys lucked the fuck out on initiative rolls. Stellan, you're at the top of the round.
Oh god. I don't know what to do. Are we just like attacking them?
Are you?
That sounds like we're not in communication with each other.
Stellan is going to cast Calm Emotions.
Awesome.
Okay.
And if it's possible to direct it, and it's not just like in everyone in an area, he's just going to direct it at Elinar's people.
All right, hang on. I'm pulling up the spell for details, so.
Yeah. No, it says each creature in a 20-foot radius sphere centered on a point you choose.
The way things are divided, yeah, you can get anyone. It might, if there's anyone in the woods, like on the opposite side of the cart, you might get them. But aside from that, you'd mostly just get.
Okay.
There are people. So okay. Stress motions, each human on a charisma saving throw, a creature can choose to fail the saving throw of wishes. When the spell ends if attacked or harmed by a spell, or if it misses any of its from. Okay. All right, we've got what's your spell DC, do you know?
I don't even know where that would be.
Okay, so it's gonna be 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16.
That doesn't sound very high.
I mean, we'll see if it's high enough.
It's apparently what fifth level DC is.
Okay. You get the spell off. You feel like as you maintain concentration, you definitely feel like it is affecting at least some of the group. Next at the top of the order, next to the order is Pip.
Can as a bonus, can I message people?
Not message. Message is an action. You can tell someone something.
Oh, well, I think I'm still in the woods, so I'm gonna just hold off.
Okay. I'm just gonna, like, throw his hands and And this is going to be a persuasion roll. He's going to go, whoa, you guys. I was just going to try and take care of a pesky bee for you. None of this is necessary. I just need to have a conversation with Elinar about this asshole Bryden coming in on our territory.
For some reason, I'm picturing you trying to stealthily throw your bow into the woods or something. Yeah. Just, like, repeat the exact scenario.
I rolled this. Okay, no, I got 28 on persuasion.
Okay. Next up is Colton, who... is oh god damn it. All right, so he's going to come out of the woods behind the cart, apparently having resisted the effect of calm emotions and not understanding that the spell was cast and is going to step up
no!
and stab the horse.
The horse?
Try and strand them there so that this is what? At least a fight that they can't get away from. And is going to hit
in for a penny, in for a pound on that Colton.
Yeah, no, the horse goes down. The cart just kind of slumps forward and the group will see if any of them they saw that. So Stellan, as you're holding them with your spell, you feel your grip on it just go away.
All of them?
Yep. If they see aggressive action taken against one of against an ally, then
the language of mine says friend. Do they really consider this horse to be a friend?
I mean,
are they friendly with the horse? Do they celebrate its birthday?
DM says yes, they do. this was their
right.
This was their mascot.
Oh god. Try a little harder than that, guys. Jeez. Okay. Well, Stellan curses internally.
First guard is up. This was the guard that resisted, the single guard, the single enemy that resisted that calm emotions anyway, which very much led me to believe we were headed to an exact repeat of the freaking. he's going to charge you, Pip, and.
Hey, I rolled a fucking 28 persuasion.
He's putting his blade up and is holding it to you and holding his action until you take any sort of aggressive action. Sio froze up. And her character sheet is not on my other things. Hang on. Vale, Crow, Siofra. I meant to jump hers over, I guess I didn't. Alright, she's going to, doopity-doo. She's going to, pull out her blasting rod and wait for orders from Pip. So she's holding a cantrip until Pip gives her the attack order. Then Thud, you're up.
Thud just watches because he doesn't know what to do.
Filcher, you're up.
So I guess what I want to do is to stealth.
All right, you zip under the cart, go ahead and roll stealth.
18.
Okay. You feel fairly hidden. Graynor is going to he's gonna prep a cantrip and then look to Alinar. And Alinar is going to look over at Colton and then shoot a sideways glare at you, Pip, and is going to say, well, evidently you have a captive audience. Jolie, you
get
up
to respond. I have to wait.
You have to wait.
Jolie is going to, so I'm still hidden in the woods, probably, right?
Yep.
Jolie had. So Jolie's gonna line up a shot at Alinar and then hold her action.
till what trigger?
Until people start swinging.
Okay. The other guards, one of the other guards does the same thing to Siofra that the one guard's doing to you, Pip. Well, he's gonna hold his action. The elven woman is gonna, are your wings out, Pip?
No, I don't think so.
All right. Then she's going to look around and ask you, what did I see fly by here? The other guard's going to hold. Stella, you're up.
So Stella is going to... Oh, God. I don't even know. Oh my gosh.
He can just wait.
Yeah, I guess. He's trying to be helpful, but... Yeah, I guess he's gonna hold his action. Just a second. Oh, wait. Oh, shit. No, Stellan's just gonna hold his action.
All right, Pip.
It's gonna go. My, oh my, a pesky fail. We could get rid of him for, get rid of him now if you'd like.
Make a is it deception or is it persuasion? I mean, the roll's the same, probably.
I mean, he's not lying.
Okay, so it's persuasion. Roll persuasion. Yeah.
Um, 17.
Is everyone just in a holding pattern through this whole next until Alinar responds to that?
Yep. Wait. No, I want the filter to do something.
All right. What do you want it to do?
I want the filter to stealthily try to take Graynor's Inquisitor badge.
Okay. This is going to be sleight of hand.
Yeah, I got a big bonus on that.
Okay, so here's the thing though, right? As it approaches, Graynor does look down and is watching it because he did roll high enough perception to see it under the cart.
So it's not going to be sleight of hand.
It's a sleight of hand to determine. It's sleight of hand to determine whether or not you get it, but not whether or not he notices, because he notices.
Okay. That's fine.
All right. Go ahead and make the roll until...
Heh. 27?
Son of a bitch. Yeah, you got it. He, like, snatches at you. But... misses, you come away with the crest.
Can I, like, fly off into the woods?
You can. He'll get an attack of opportunity as you pull out of his attack range, so he'll get one swing at the filcher.
That's cool.
Yeah, so he is going to do that. That is...
Did he hit?
Yay! The filcher flies off with his crest, and he just goes, oh!
Okay, cool.
I really wish I could respond.
Graynor's turn is immediately after the filcher's, so he's going to... he's gonna use a guiding bolt at it as it's flying away. 13, 14. That's gonna hit. So that'll do.
Okay, if the filter's gonna get hit, I want it to be prepared to, like, fling the crest off, like, into the brush.
Well, we'll see. It takes 17 damage. Radiant damage from the hit.
It has 18 HP.
It is not down. It is, however, glowing now.
Okay.
Alinar is going to, on his turn, he's going to gesture to his guards over towards Colton while still looking at Pip, and is going to say, "Are they not with you?" Jolie, you're up.
So Jolie is going to, as stealthily as she can, I guess, try to get within throwing range of the filter.
Mm-hmm. So roll stealth.
All right, here we go. Do not have that as a skill. 21 with my dex.
All right. You manage not to shake the woods too much and try and position yourself in throwing range under your filcher. One of the guards, the one that was over by the horse, that, like, steps over towards Colton and takes a swing. It misses, or at least Colton kind of parries it and gives wisdom save. Yeah. Does not give Pip a glare or a betrayed look. Manages not to sell, but not to give away the what Pip's pulling. Blue is up. Has not gotten any commands from Pip, so continues holding his action. Can she even do anything? Can she? She just gives Graynor an annoyed look, like, seriously, you didn't kill the thing, but, like, doesn't say anything. The elven woman does. Then the other guards are staying in formation. Stellan, you're up.
So Stellan is gonna... Oh, God. It's really nothing. It's just super nothing. Maybe message Pip and say, like, do you have a plan? Is there anything I can do?
Pip, you're up next, so...
Okay, so... If I use, like, an action and a bonus action, can I re-message and speak to...
You can ride the coattail of Stellan's message and just send something back real quick.
I was gonna reply, I always have a plan. He's gonna say, I must say, I was in quite the hurry to catch you. I deeply apologize if I did not notice any pesky intruders or would-be assassins, but I assure you, I would be more than happy to help you take out the trash.
I mean, your deception and persuasion rolls are the same anyway, so just go ahead and roll.
They are not the same.
I thought they were.
Persuasion's plus 11, deception is plus 6.
Oh, you picked persuasion as one of your things that you doubled. Yeah, okay, so...
And I didn't lie in when I said any of that.
I mean, that's true. Okay. I'm not sure I'll let you do this every time, but yeah, go ahead and roll and add your persuasion. Alinar then gestures you, gestures towards Colton and says, then by all means.
Are we out of, like, are we still doing
initiative? We're still in initiative, yeah. Colton is going to, make an attack against the guard that's fighting him. It hits. Some damage to that guard. That guard is going to swing back with a natural one. So as he swings, Colton's cut kind of connects with the back of his hand and the sword goes flying off into the woods. Siofra still holding the cantrip, still waiting. Thud.
That does nothing. But, like, what the shit is happening?
Filcher.
Filcher throws badge to Jolie.
Yeah, it appears to just be throwing it into the woods, at which point Graynor does go, really? Really? go ahead and make a dexterity check, Jolie.
Eight.
You don't, it's not a graceful catch, but you do catch it.
Right.
It's almost more like it's dropped directly into your chest, and then you kind of fall back and hold it.
Alright.
So... Everyone else, I think, is still in a holding pattern. We get back up to you, Pip.
Okay, so... Hip is gonna, like, bow. And he's gonna walk up to, what was the name, Colton? Mm-hmm. And then he's going to cast Inflict Wounds at a level 3.
Okay. That's a... Was that a Constitution save? Hang on. Or is that... No, that's a melee spell attack, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, go ahead and roll and add your Wisdom modifier plus 4. So...
You must be shitting me.
Oh no.
Natural one?
Shitting me.
Natural one?
What is it?
It's a natural
one. No.
So you walk up to the guard and Colton fighting, and you reach out to cast Inflict Wounds on Colton. So the spell is at the ready and coming, like, pulsing through your hand. And you reach out at the exact second that, like, the guard recoiling raises his arm, and you accidentally touch the guard. Go ahead and roll damage.
Oh my god.
Oh, jeez.
As you do this, you hear Siofra say sarcastically with a slight smile in her voice, "We're gonna need to talk about this after we get back."
Where is it? Cast a spell. 3d10. D10. Okay, so I'm rolling 5d10.
God. Oh my god.
33. Do I add anything to that?
I mean, I don't think so.
Okay.
Yeah, so no, just 33. Yeah, no, the, like, as the guard is pulling back, bumps his elbow into your hand, suddenly, like, black veins start, like, going across him, and, like, cuts start appearing all over him, and he, like, screams and then falls down into a puddle of blood.
As a bonus action, like, slowly turn and look at Eleanor and go, "Oops."
Well, he is not in the initiative order anymore. Colton gives you a, like, nod of solidarity, and then turns and then, like, jumps up and makes an attack on Alinar with a fucking natural one.
Oh no!
So, like, he jumps up triumphantly and his foot catches on, like, the hitch that, like, connects the dead horse to the cart, and he just face plants against the side of the cart.
Oh god.
Siofra looks at the guard with the sword to her throat. And at this point, everyone who was holding actions goes off at the same time.
Okay.
So, Jolie, make your shot.
Okay, so Jolie is going to shoot at Eleanor.
Only in D&D.
Oh, God. Okay. So, 18. 18, yeah.
Against Eleanor. That will hit. Go ahead and roll your new damage.
I don't have it. What is it?
Oh dear.
Oh
Gotta pull it up in the PDF real quick, so.
Okay, thank you. Sorry, I don't have that yet.
Yeah, I know. I need to update your guys' character sheets and stuff.
That's okay.
I'm gonna grab a glass of wine, because I need one.
Oh my god! I know!
That is... Okay, so you roll, and then you're gonna add your... in firearm combination. It is a fresh slip. Firearm is a weapon. It's a normal range. Okay, so it is a... roll a d20, and then add your dexterity modifier +3 to see if you hit.
Oh, I already hit though, right?
Oh yeah. Sorry, you rolled natural 18. So yeah, it's gonna be 2d6 piercing damage. And then in your hands it does an additional, like, stupid amount of damage. Because these
I just got 6 and 6.
Very nice. Now go ahead and roll 2 more d6.
4 and 6, so 22.
All right, that is not an insignificant amount of damage.
I like this new gun.
Yeah.
So 12 piercing damage. What's the other kind of damage?
Thunder damage.
Damn.
Is anyone dead?
Nope.
No, but I think Alinar I did 22 damage.
Alinar is not as big a fan of Jolie's gun as she is, though. so, at this point, Siofra is firing off her frostbite. So it's a con save on the part of, she's going to go for Graynor, because Graynor is squaring off of Pip, or is trying to hit Pip. He fails the crap out of that con save. So that is 4 damage and disadvantage on the next attack. Bad damage roll. then each of the guards, the one let Pip step out of range, which is, in retrospect, probably not a great idea. So that is 10, 11, 12. That is not going to be enough to hit Siofra, is it? I highly, highly doubt it. Nope. Okay, so that's a miss. So you guys had a good first round of combat. Weird surprise round of combat. I don't know what the fuck to call it. Anyway, back at the okay. So now it is Siofra's turn, not her held action.
Wait, wasn't Stellan holding, or does that not count if last time he messaged?
What was Stellan holding? I forgot.
I mean, he was just like gonna wait and see what happened.
Yeah.
But at the very least. He wanted to do Bardic Inspiration. Is that something he can do? That's a bonus thing.
Given the context, I will let him inspire someone. Who do you want to
inspire? I
want to
inspire Colton.
Okay.
Because he just face planted and I feel like he could use it.
He could use it. Ooh, sympathy inspiration. Okay. He has the inspiration die he can use later then. Next up is... Thud.
Right. So, is there like an area of enemies in the thing at 20 square feet allies?
I mean, you'd hit Colton and Pip, but that's up to you.
Yeah, I will. I'll go ahead and conjure animals.
Okay. So that's 2 hyenas, right?
Yes.
Is it two or is it just one?
What challenge rating were hyenas?
Challenge rating one, but that has also changed with your, like how what extent you can summon things has changed because of your switch to. Wait, no.
But it should be better.
You're right, it should be. It's what you can transform into that's changed, not what you can summon. So yeah, you can still summon two hyenas, and they have extra HP.
Okay, and then I have to roll initiative for them. Seventeen.
So yep, you have hyenas. Next up is Filcher with a whopping one HP.
Yeah, Filcher is about to die. So it's just gonna dive bomb Alinar.
Sure. I mean, you were pretty much there last round, so yeah, you'd be able to get to him if you want to make your attack against him.
I do. So.
Oh. Hang on.
What?
I'm sorry. Jolie, when you shot Alinar, he disappeared.
Oh. Okay.
So, Filcher, well, you do not have Alinar as a viable target.
Filcher is going to dive bomb Graynor then.
Okay, that's fair. Go ahead and make your attack against him.
Yeah, so I roll, let me see. So 21.
That hits. Go ahead and roll damage.
+1d4 plus 5. So let's see how we do here. 7.
All right, so 7 damage to Graynor, who is less than happy about this. All right, Graynor is now up. He is also at disadvantage on his next weapon attack. He is going for Pip and makes...
Is double disadvantage a thing?
No. It doesn't matter because his first roll was a natural one anyway.
Many natural ones.
Right? This has been the failiest fight of the campaign. He like takes a swing and then just like gets his blade stuck in the side of the cart, and like it takes a second for him to actually let me see if. Colton ducks out of the way just in time to get stuck in the side of the cart, and then he like spends his what would be his second attack, he spends pulling it out of the cart. Good job, Greenland. All right, so give me just a second to see what's going on here. We have. Okay. Next in the order is Jolie.
Can I do like a perception thing to see if I see Alinar or like where he went?
Sure, go ahead and roll.
I got a 9, so that's not gonna fly.
Okay.
Was that my action?
No. I'll make that bonus action.
Okay, in that case, I turn and I shoot Graynor.
Okay, go ahead and make your ranged weapon tech.
What did I add to it? It's not gonna hit.
You add your dexterity modifier plus 3.
So that's 9 all told.
No,
yeah.
That's not gonna be enough. It just pings off as armor. One of the guards, or this is the guard that's gonna take a swing at Siofra. That's gonna hit. That'll do. Vicious guard. At this point, it's gonna be a really? At this point, there's a sound and a cable zips in, wraps around the other guard, and they just go and get pulled into the woods.
Woohoo!
Astrid's gonna go around and take a swing at Colton, who is prone, so the attack has advantage. That's gonna hit. And that is going to be 4.
Don't forget about the inspiration dice.
Yeah, unfortunately, it doesn't help in this exact circumstance. So yeah, that is 27 points of slashing damage to Colton, who is very badly wounded, but not down. Let's see. You don't have multi-attack.
Wait, can Az?
Oh shit!
Oh,
she
shit.
Does have multi-attack,
I
so
kinda
she gets
missed,
to take another swing.
I kind of missed my. Oh no. I have Cutting Words, which is as a reaction, I can use one of my Bardic Inspiration dice to reduce an enemy's attack by that roll.
You can go
is
ahead.
Is that something I could do?
Yeah, that takes your reaction. It will reveal your location.
Okay, so I'm going to not do that then. Sorry,
Colton. Okay. All right, her next attack is going to... So her first one just comes down on him really hard, and he starts trying... He tries to roll to the side, but it still catches his shoulder really badly, and he's bleeding pretty profusely. She swings it around and comes down at him again, and he just barely rolls out of the way. That is going to be her turn. Now the guard who's in a solo duel with Blue is gonna really suck. Stellan, you're up.
So I'm going to definitely, Stellan is 100% going to try to see what happened to Alinar.
All right, go ahead.
And he's got a really big perception bonus, so.
Yep.
Okay, so I got, like, with my perception bonus, I think I got, like, a 25?
Because of that, I will let you make a survival check.
Uh-oh. What do I add to that?
Wisdom.
Oh, shit. 10. But I plus 1 because I don't have that skill and I'm a jack of all trades, 11.
That is correct. Looking around, you do not see Alinar. You do see what you kind of think. You're not trained in tracking. but you do see what you would imagine in some dramatic CSI play would be considered a quote-unquote fresh pair of tracks heading back down the road back towards Vale.
I'm gonna go after that.
Okay. Are you staying hidden or are you just bolting?
I think I'm invisible, right?
Oh, that's right, you are.
So I'm gonna be invisible and I'm gonna bolt.
Duel of the Fates while both parties are invisible. This is going to be fun. Pip, you're up.
Am I allowed to stealth?
You can step back into the woods and stealth, yes. And since you are a rogue, that would be your bonus action.
Okay. Then I'm gonna... And once I'm stealthed, I get a advantage on attacks. A thing, or is
yes.
that not a thing? I don't know.
If you are successful at stealth from your target, then you have an advantage on your attack against them.
Okay, I'm gonna attempt a stealth roll.
Okay.
I did well. 29.
You're super stealthy.
And now I want to do an attack on Greynor.
If you stepped back into the woods, though, you did step out of melee with Greynor, which means he would get an attack of opportunity against you.
Yeah, that's what I was asking. Like,
oh, okay. Yeah, no, so that's up to you. Do you want to do that and let him get the swing?
Sure. Okay. He has disadvantage because I haven't been hit yet.
Okay. He rolled another fucking natural one.
Yeah!
So, yeah, go for it.
And his sword just still be stuck in the wall.
I mean, yeah, like, he just got it unstuck, and now he just goes, and it's stuck again.
Oh my god. Okay. Now I'm gonna attack him. Whatever, I'm just gonna hit him with another... Well, no, I'm successfully away. Yeah, no, I'm gonna start raining arrows down.
Alright, go ahead and take your shot. Sharpshooter or no?
Everything.
Okay.
I need to take a break so badly, but I am so invested in every part of this battle.
Go ahead and run and use the restroom. I'm trying to make sure we wrap up in time because I know you've got to go before too long. So I'm trying to see if we can get this fight going as quick as we can.
Do I have a thing where I could either get advantage, if I had advantage, deal more damage?
It increases your chance to hit. That's what your ring does. You can Ring of the Dead shot.
Oh,
you get
my
plus
ring.
Yeah, you get plus three to the attack.
Yeah, okay. So...
If you would have stacked advantage. Or no, you can forego an instance of advantage to get plus three.
Okay, now I'll just take the advantage.
Okay. So go ahead and roll twice, take the higher result, add 5 to it, let me know what it is.
23.
That hits. Go ahead and roll damage.
Okay.
Okay, so sharpshooter,
10
damage. So 10 plus whatever you, plus a d6 plus 6. And he has to make his wisdom save.
Yes. He's not close to an allied unit though, is he?
No.
No, think. 8 plus 6 is 14. 24, I guess.
Okay. That hurts.
And then he has to make his sanity roll or whatever.
I did. Alright, so, next up is Colton. who is no longer the target on the field with the most damage on them. Gonna use half of his movement to stand up, and then is gonna take a swing against Astrid. And there's no... he doesn't hit.
He can't use his dice?
I mean, I'm not going to.
Okay.
Maybe he's gonna hang on to it, because I mean it may be a but I know what her AC is, and he's not gonna hit it. So
okay.
It's better if he saves the die. Hyenas, you're up.
Is there like a weak looking guard low on health?
There is one that is in melee with Siofra that does not.
No! You're gonna attack Greynor because that'll give Pip an advantage against him too.
Okay, so the hyenas come up and start flanking Greynor. go ahead and have them make their attacks.
Okay, and they're at an advantage. First attack. Not good. Where's it? D hyena plus 2 to hit. 12.
No.
Okay, second. 19.
That'll hit. Go ahead and roll damage.
Okay. 3d6 piercing. 7.
So yes, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12. Okay, so yep. Okay, so that it bites his side, and he kind of gives an aggravated hurrah! Like battle yell. He's pretty pissed. Siofra is going to. What are you gonna do? You are going to. Would that work? That would work. Okay. So she is going to spin on Greynor and use Lightning Lure, which he resists. So, never mind. That could have been epic. Thud, you're up.
Shit, Thud. I'm not used to fighting with Thud. Okay. You know what? Thud is going to cast. Where is that? Healing Word on Colton. Oh.
Yeah.
That's so nice.
I mean, Colton's not looking great.
And we'll do it at level 2.
Okay.
So 2d4 plus a spell casting modifier.
Which is what? So Thud's wisdom.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
Okay. So the 2d4. 4. Plus 4, so he healed 8 damage.
Okay, that's not nothing. All right, so Filcher, you're still alive.
Somehow, improbably. definitely going to sting Graynor again. Yeah.
Make an attack roll.
Filcher has +7 to hit. Okay. 23.
That hits. Go ahead and roll damage.
So that's how much do you, when do you, I keep having to, I have to open up like 1d4 +5. Okay. All right. So 7.
Okay.
Oh, looks like Scott's running late, by the way, so I might be able to stay longer.
We still want to try and keep up a decent pace, but yeah, we also don't want to cut off in the middle of this fight. So yeah, that happened. Graynor's up, and he's going to use a Thunder Wave, because he is pissed, and he is going to do it at level 4. So...
Shit!
So let me pull up the details of that spell. All right. So that is everyone within 15 foot. Okay, so yeah, he's gonna. So this is gonna hit the Filcher. Cube burgeoning from. Yeah, okay, so this is gonna hit the Filcher. It's gonna hit Pip. It's gonna hit Astrid. It's gonna hit Colton.
It's gonna hit Pip.
Yeah.
Isn't Pip in the woods?
What is this range on this thing?
Just 15 feet. Pip's in the woods shooting, right?
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. No. I mean, I guess not. I am envisioning this as a more narrow road, but I guess you guys backed. I will allow Pip not to be in it, but
the hyenas probably.
It'll hit. Yeah, and the hyenas. So all targets affected need to make Constitution saving throws.
I mean, the Filcher's gonna die no matter what. Do I really need to bother?
No, Filcher's gone.
Okay.
Oh, yes, Constitution. 17 and 9.
The 17 succeeds, so it takes half damage. So. So 15 damage to anything that fails, and 7 damage to anything that succeeds.
So what is their like extra HP?
Oh right, that's fair. Their extra HP is. Give me a second. Two HP per hit die, so, you have, so, 12 extra HP.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, I think that is the case. Let me double check something real quick, it might be less than that, but. HP.
Because their regular HP is, like, 5.
Oh, really? Oh right, they're regular hyenas, not giant hyenas. Forgot about that. Okay.
Yeah.
H-I-J-K-L-M-C-G. Okay, hyena normal HP is 5. So. Says an extra okay per hit die. Okay, no, it looks like hyenas only have 1 hit die, so that just boosts them to 7. So.
Okay, then they're both dead.
Okay. Hyenas dissipate. Colton. Barely succeeds. So that's 7 to him. And then yeah, filter's gone. So yeah, so that was that and Master took 7. So yeah, there's a burst of energy and loud thunderous boom. And then Greynor, it also pushes all those targets back 10 feet. He is then going to use his movement to turn and run his full movement down the road away from the City of Vale. So, Jolie, you're up.
Shoot Greynor.
All right, go ahead and make a your attack roll.
Alright, give me just a second. I want to see what I add to that.
Okay. 3 plus your dex modifier, which is 2, so 5. You'll add 5 to it.
In that case, 22.
That's a hit. Go ahead and roll damage. Which is fucking...
And what's damage again?
4d6.
So, the first 2 make 9, and then the next 2 make 5. So 14 in all. But the first... So 9 for whatever piercing, and then 5 for thunder, or whatever that is.
Yeah, I mean, as he's, like, running down the road, you just go, and there's a loud bang, and it hits him, and he still seems to be up and running, but he does not look great. The guard that is in... melee with Seofro is going to take a swing at her. That's a natural 1.
Good!
So, I mean, it's just going to miss. I'm not going to have everyone get disarmed every time there's a natural 1. We'd be in a slap fight at this point. Blue is going to hit, and that is... 'Cause you shot Greynor. So
yeah.
Not you, Pip. So you are not in stealth at the moment.
Correct.
Okay. Astrid is going to go ahead and try and finish off Colton. She misses her first swing. Her second is... How much does she add to that? That is going to hit unless you want to cutting words, Stellan. And then it might...
Can I do it from where I am?
Yes, but you'll reveal your location.
Still invisible.
You are still invisible.
Yeah, I'll go ahead and do cutting words.
Okay. So go ahead and roll... What is your inspiration die right now?
I don't know. D8.
It's a D8, yeah. So go ahead and roll a D8.
Okay. 8!
Yep, that as you yell something, she like looks up startled and the attack just barely misses Colton.
Yay!
This is the guard that's another natural 1, because apparently you can't hire guards. Stella,
so like stormtroopers.
Like this, yeah, no, this is like that level of hilarious.
So would I possibly be able to kind of what I'm trying to do is. Okay, so with prestidigitation, I would be able to soil any object, and I was wondering if I could make Eleanor's clothes really dirty so I could see the dirt on them.
You would need yes, if you have, if you give me your, if you think you know where he is, like, in a very kind of specific term, you could just try to, like, prestidigitate about, like, in a straight line about 10 feet
from where, like, the tracks are.
Yeah, but so far,
I'm, like, booking it.
Yeah, so far you're seeing a continuous trail. You haven't found where they, like, stop or are being made yet. So you can take a best guess blind shot, but that would be difficult.
I guess I'll try. I'm just, it's not going to stop me from running, right?
That is correct. And it's a cantrip, okay, so you're not wasting anything.
Might as well.
Yeah, go ahead and I guess I'll make this a ranged spell attack, so you're rolling your d20 and you're adding your charisma plus 3.
Seriously?
Yeah.
24?
Okay. Yeah, you fire, like, just kind of, like, out of nowhere, water kind of sprays around. Oh, hey, I will let you retract it. I will, because I also need to put this in perspective. If you make a ranged spell attack, your invisibility will go away because it is an attack.
Oh. So, but the prestidigitation is not an attack.
Yeah, I'm letting you use it as an attack because you're trying to shoot at something with it, which is not really how the spell's intended.
Oh, fine. Okay, I'm just gonna not then. God.
Okay.
That was a good roll, though.
Sorry.
Ugh. Fine. So I guess I'm gonna go ahead and give another bardic inspiration die to Colton because he seems like he's in dire straits here.
Sure. So yeah, he's so you do that. You kind of give a little bit of a, like, send some musical vibrations through the ground to him. So Pip, you're up.
All right. I'm just gonna take a shot at. Yeah, I'm just gonna take a straight up shot with sharpshooter at Greymoor.
Okay.
So plus 5 to hit.
Yep.
23.
That'll go ahead and roll damage.
That's 2d6 plus 16. Is it 24 again? Yeah, 24.
Damn.
And then I'm gonna stealth.
Yeah. The arrow just goes and sinks into Granor's back, like finding the right chink in the armor, and he just goes down. Like, you just see the figure just go on the ground.
He rolled a 30 stealth.
He also failed his wisdom save, but it's not very significant right now.
Wait, he could have a last dying thought.
I mean, he's not dead yet. He's unconscious.
Oh.
Jolie, you're up.
I'm going to shoot Astrid.
Okay.
Eighteen.
That does not hit.
Seriously?
Glances off the armor.
Oh shit.
Next up is the guard that is fighting Siofra, who's gonna hit her finally. I'm not a stormtrooper. That's actually a decent hit. Just kind of slashes kind of across her chest and draws blood.
Okay.
still hear scuffling going on farther in the woods. Now Astrid's gonna, after that shot, no, Colton's still there. So she's, Colton's still there.
Colton.
Somehow.
So she's going to take, that's a natural 20.
Sorry, bye, Colton. Good night.
So that is going to be, she didn't roll shit for the damage. Okay, so that is going to be,
does it matter?
With a critical hit, that is 6 from the sword itself. She's burning a, six, so just another 6, and then, so 16 total, and with that, Colton stops moving on the ground. Then she looks up and glares daggers at Jolie. Scuffling still going on in the woods. Stellan, you're up.
Can I, like, re-roll for survival or something to see if I can track him better?
Sure.
I mean, it's, you add your, what?
Oh, you're right, sorry. So you'd add your wisdom modifier +1, because jack of all trades.
I mean, 12, so I got 1 better than I did last time.
You pick up your pace, you follow the footprints until they just end.
I mean, if I recall, Bit can teleport. Oh, wait, no, was it Gear that Gear can teleport? Never mind. I don't know, maybe he can teleport.
Huh?
Never, don't pay attention to me.
Cool. So is it possible for me to, like, scoop up some dirt and just, like, throw it up in the air?
Sure.
And see where it lands?
You are not proficient with this weapon. So go ahead and this would technically be considered improvised weaponry, which is actually a thing. Go ahead and roll a d20 and add your dexterity modifier.
Let me see what my dex modifier is. 9?
Yeah, you go up, you scoop up dirt, you throw it up in the air. A little bit gets in your mouth on its way back down. It's uncomfortable.
Well, that was fun.
Pip, you're up.
Okay, so who the fuck is left?
There is a guard fighting Seofra. There's still scuffling going on in the woods from the direction the one guard got hookshot pulled in. And then fucking Astrid.
This bitch. Oh man. Okay. Do we have any helpful spells? Wait, did Zed get to go?
Did we get thrown off order? If so, when?
No, Stellan just went. And so Pip is after Stellan, right?
Yeah, but Thud didn't go since Pip shot Greynor dead.
Did he not? He didn't try to heal. That wasn't him healing Colton.
Wasn't that the time before?
I don't remember.
I may have messed up the order, but I'm not sure where I pick it up to compensate. So, Pip, you're up. Sorry. Okay.
Well, from stealth, I guess Pip is gonna take a shot at whatever her AC is. Jesus.
Yep, go for it.
Okay.
Yep. Regular shot +5. Or just a +5, so you're doing a sharpshooter.
Yeah, but it's at advantage because I'm stealthed, yes.
Yep. When did you stealth?
As a bonus action after
okay.
I shot Great Noir, I rolled a 30.
Oh, yeah, then, yeah, okay, you're at advantage.
It doesn't matter. Because I got a 3 and a 4.
Good job. Those don't hit. I'm
going to stealth.
Go for it.
Unless she has a reaction.
All right, so,
okay.
Oh, yeah.
Not quite as good. 18.
Okay. I haven't been deleting dead people. All right. Siofra is going to... She's got her own guard. She's still... But she has been ignoring. She's, like, sincerely just let the guard swing at her and been shooting at other people. So she's, at this point, going to turn back and... oh, right. Her sheet's on here. No, she's gonna keep focusing on the fight overall. She reaches up and there is bands of like cold energy starts wrapping around Astrid and tries to restrain her, and Astrid like starts to get restrained with a hold person spell, locks eyes with Siofra, and then forces it off.
Lovely.
Thud, you're up.
What do I have? Whatever. Thud's gonna attempt a hold person as well.
Okay. What's Thud's DC? That is 3, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Again, she shakes it off. Jolie, you're up. Unless you want to use a bonus action, Thud.
No. Well,
prep that shillelagh.
I mean, I'll whip out my shillelagh.
All right. Jolie, you're up.
Okay, I'm a shooter.
All right. Go ahead and roll an attack.
Oh, God. Okay. 21?
That hits. Go ahead and roll damage.
Okay. All right. So 18, the first 9 are the piercing damage, and the second 9 are the thunder damage.
That stings. Yeah, she takes the hit. The guard attacking Siofra continues to stormtrooper. Scuffling in the woods keeps happening. And then Astrid is gonna lean down into a run and charge straight at Jolie.
Isn't Jolie like in the sky?
Oh,
you can.
Could I be?
You can be floating. Yes. Let me see if that is gonna change what's going on. Any. Yeah, that's not gonna happen. Yeah, with that, she's going to... Alright, so not Jolie, Pip. She's going straight for Pip. who she does apparently see. She is gonna take a swing. Yeah, she'll.
I still haven't been hit, so.
Yeah, so it's still a disadvantage. So that's a natural 20, so good thing it's at disadvantage. And a natural 2. So. So her first attack misses. Her second one, still at disadvantage, is a natural 18. So that's going to be 24 to hit.
Shit, that hits me.
So that's going to be 7 damage. Which she will... Yeah, she can burn. She's going to burn one of her level 2 spell slots to do a Divine Smite upon connection. And do it... So that's 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14... 15, 16, 17, 18,
19, 20, 21, 22. 22
damage. Total.
Is that in it? Okay, so total 22?
Total 22. Oof. Oof. Okay. So... Now it is Stellan.
Can I try the frickin' survival check again?
Go for it. Where are you trying it?
Like,
going into the woods? You going farther down the road? Are you going back?
There's no way that like a perception check will give me any information about where Alinar, if Alinar is there where the tracks stop.
You are welcome to attempt a perception check.
Okay, because I have a big perception bonus. So, okay, oh my god, okay.
You might see some movement much farther down the road, but you're just looking for possible like disturbed sand, and there isn't. Like, you sincerely do not see disturbed sand. You do see little bits of like grass moving, and like not on the road, like off to the side of the road, much farther down. And it's not much to go on. It could just be a breeze, but.
Okay. Is it possible for me to like take one of my like fans and hold it out in front of me and like charge at the area where the footsteps stop?
Oh yeah. You can do that.
And then see if I run into anything.
Yes.
Okay.
You
and is that also? I do.
You don't.
Oh, I don't. Is that also in the direction of the grass I just saw moving?
It's in the direction.
It's cool. Not, I just keep
no,
running.
Yeah, it's not near. Yeah, so yeah, you just keep.
I'm going for that breeze.
Ah. Yeah, I just wanted to make sure when Astrid made her second attack against Pip, that was also at disadvantage, right?
Yes,
and she rolled an 18.
Yes, I said that.
Dang.
Pip, you're up.
Okay. Pamela's gonna give a smarmy wink if it doesn't take a bonus action.
It doesn't.
And then he's gonna spread his wings and take flight.
You wanna use your bonus action to disengage?
Well, I have to use my bonus action to spread my wings,
okay.
But I'll use my action to disengage take flight.
Okay. Yeah. Then yeah, you do that. And she doesn't get an attack of opportunity on you. Yep. So next up is Siofra, who is now realizing that she is Astrid's most likely next target. And is going to try and She's going to go ahead and she does a quick incantation with her hands. She'll use her bonus action to disengage with the guard, and she's going to move at double speed down the road because she has hasted herself. Thought you're up.
Is Colton still kind of near Astrid?
She could easily walk over to him in one turn, so yes.
Okay, but it doesn't matter because I'm just targeting one person, so I can still, like, aim erupting earth so it only hits her.
Yes, that is true.
And he's gonna go ahead and cast Erupting Earth.
Alright. Okay, Erupting Earth. They make a... Is this a Dex?
Dexterity saving.
Luckily, Dex is not her forte. Yeah, she fails that.
I rolled 29 for the damage.
Okay.
And she's now kind of in rough terrain or whatever.
Yeah. Yep, that hurt. She's looking pretty rough, finally. Jolie, you're up.
Shoot her!
Alright.
Jesus. Twenty-two
hits. Go ahead and roll damage.
Oh, good. Not a very good damage roll. 6 overall, so the first... So 3 piercing and then 3 thunder.
Alright. She... is she's got a decision to make. All right, this guard who was in melee with Siofra, but then Siofra like booked it out of dodge, is going to turn and start running away down the road, away from Vale. Like, as soon as he gets, like, because he's been squared off with her, as soon as she runs, he looks around and is like, oh, shit, they're gone. His backup is down for the most part, so he's running. At this point, there's another, and the guard who just started running down the road suddenly has a cable wrapped around his ankle and just gets pulled into the woods. Oof. Astrid gives, like, looks around, appears to pretty barely be standing, takes her greatsword, like, walks over the moves over the rough terrain, takes it, and just plants it in Colton's back.
Shit.
And then lets her sword go and puts her hands up. Stellan, you're up.
Am I any closer to the moving grass?
You're closer to where it was, yeah. You did a full turn's movement towards it.
Can I see any more grass moving?
You can do another perception check.
Jesus. Okay. I got this bonus.
He's burnt several spells. And you're still
I got 20.
Sort of keeping pace.
20 on perception.
At this point you're pretty sure, in spite of the fact that he seems not to be leaving a trail of any kind, but you're pretty sure he's running back toward Vale. And if you just keep running at full speed down this road, you'll at least stay the same distance behind him. You're not sure if you're faster than him or not.
Okay. Can I kind of gauge what that distance is?
You've rolled really ridiculous perception checks, so I will say you have figured it's probably
What?
You probably shouldn't be saying anything.
Oh.
Any trail you can possibly find right now is... You're not gonna catch him. If you keep moving and keep pace, then you might be able to see him if and when he loses concentration on his invisibility, but that's kind of your best bet.
Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and, if I can, use minor illusion to make it sound like Graynor is calling out. What do you call a cardinal? Like, what's the honorific? Like,
Your grace, I guess.
Your grace. To make it sound like Graynor is shouting, "Your grace, your grace."
Yep. You do that thing. I guess go ahead and roll deception.
Yeah. All right. 19.
Thud and Pip roll and Jolie roll wisdom saves.
We're not too so far away that they wouldn't hear that.
I mean, no, you're much closer to them than you are to the person you're trying to alert with this.
Thud rolled a 6.
Jolie got 14, I think. Let me see. Yeah, 14.
Yeah. Thud, you hear what sounds like more guards coming from the other side of the road, from the other direction down the road. Everyone else seems mostly fine. Seems to mostly realize that it's not actually more guards coming. Then, Pip, you're up.
Shit. Hold on, I'm gonna relocate real quick.
I mean, we're almost done, though, but yeah. We probably gotta call it sooner than later.
Yeah.
Puppy.
Okay. Well, if we are gonna call it real quick.